each day I'm going to be eating foods that I associate with my childhood. I feel like this is a really big scare for me, is children's food, because thinking back to my childhood, I feel like that's where my eating disorder stems from, and I didn't like my image then, and that's why it carried on all the way through to where I am now. So if I go back and eat the foods and feel comfortable with them from when I was a child, I feel like that would be a really big step in my recovery. So let's see how this day plans out. Let's go.
Delights Brandy and the way it hits her lips. She's a rock and roll survivor with pendulum hips. She's got deep brown eyes that have seen it all.
So I actually was so indecisive about my cereal that I thought it was best to get Benji to choose what I ate, as he is still a child and lives freely with his food. He said that this morning he would have Cocoa Pops, so I made him do it for me. Although I always felt guilty with it in my childhood, I still ate it, and I'm learning to eat it now without the guilt. So it's important to start somewhere. Working at a night. Another thing my eating disorder has lied to me about. I literally said to Benji, oh, I don't think I should have Cocoa Pops. I don't like Cocoa Pops. These are so yummy. What the hell? No wonder everyone likes them, because they're yummy. What the hell? My brain was like, this is just pure evidence. My brain fully lies to me the whole time. So how can I believe the things it tells me when I know categorically it lies to me? When it tells me things that I know aren't true, I need to proper take them on board, because they are clearly not true.
But there was called the Avenue, the barman used to call a little Lisa Looney Tunes. She went down on almost anyone. From the hard time living till the Chelsea days, from when her hair was sweet blonde till the day it turned gray, she said, L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N, you got more than money and sense, my friend, you got heart.
In my childhood, I mostly had packed lunches, so I've made myself, a packed lunch on a plate, which is basically a lunch, and I've made myself a chicken and mayo wrap with veg and a baby bell and some Pringles and even a bottle of water that I put in my packed lunch when I was younger. I used to love having this for lunch and waking up and looking what was inside my packed lunch. So what's the point of worrying about it when I used to have it as a child and enjoyed it? And it's just the cheese that's getting to me the most. When I was putting this on my plate, I had everything and I thought, I need an extra thing, because I didn't just have a wrap, veg and crisps in my packed lunch. I always had something extra, and I haven't had cheese in so long. But if I used to have it as a child, and what's the difference between having a bit of cheese and not a bit of cheese? There's no difference for my body, but a lot for my head, and that's the most important thing. So it's just repeating and going with what I know is the best thing for me right now.
And you're going your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart. And you're going your own way.
I actually really liked my packed lunch on a plate. It reminded me of when I was younger and I wouldn't base that to eat whether or not on the time or what was the option, and rather that I was just hungry and the food that I ate was because I need energy, and it's just a normal thing to eat food, whatever it is, and it's made me happy and I'm glad I had it, and it was actually really yummy, including the baby bear. So I'm trying to look after my inside little Livy as much as my outside big Livy, adult Livy. So for my afternoon snack, I'm struggling a bit, because I get this quite a lot where I don't want to have a afternoon snack because I'm just not hungry, and then I think I'm having dinner soon and I could just wait. and then time ticks on, and then I know I've listened to my eating disorder and I've got away with not having a snack. So I know I keep on repeating this action, just forcing myself to have an afternoon snack, because I know that's what I need. And if I get away with having it once, then it just makes it so much harder the next day. So although it's quite late today because I went out, it's 6 o'clock, I'm gonna be having my dinner soon-ish. I know I still need to fit in this afternoon snack and stick to my meal plan. So,
yeah.
What snack should I have to recreate our childhood memories?
Like a map on their face, and Joey was an artist just living out a case, but his best work was his letters home. Extended works of fiction about imaginary success, when chorus girls and neon were his closest thing to friends. But to a writer, the truth is no big deal. And from the hard time living to the sleepless nights and the black and blue body from the weekend fights, he'd say L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you're going your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back.
I actually learned a lot with hypnotherapy that the way we build up ourselves and how we are from a younger self is completely the way we are, obviously, as we are now. However, there isn't a moment in time where we could change how we brought up our younger selves. And what I'm really trying to do is to re-bring up myself in a different way of thinking. So in a different way of, it's sad, when I think back now, I used to always associate skinniness with happiness. And now I'm trying so hard to really rewire my brain into knowing that that's completely, completely wrong. Because I've been there, and I've been the skinniest I've ever been. I'm underweight, and in hospital, my eating disorder was still not happy. So however skinny you are and whatever your appearance does not determine your happiness. And there is so much more to happiness, like the inside of you and actually how you've brought up yourself into knowing that happiness is not determined by your appearance. And actually happiness is by changing your way of thinking and making the world a better place. Because if you're happy within yourself, you make others around you happy, and then keeps on growing, which to me is real happiness rather than your outside appearance. And for dessert, I am going to have some custard, which I've been putting off having for so long now. I've kept on telling myself that I'm going to have custard for dessert, and I keep on putting it off. So I did have this a lot as a child, and I know I like custard. So that's a good thing for me to be having for dessert and trying in my new life, in my new way of living.
You're going your own way. Just breathe in the air and blink in the light. My last night on earth.
So for late night snack, I will be having some fruit and a chocolate cereal bar. I will not be recording this as I just want to put my phone away for the night. But I just wanted to say that I promise I'm having it, and that I'm gonna go to sleep soon and watch some Killing Eve whilst eating my snack. So, night night everyone, thank you so much for watching. Please all like and subscribe and pass on the message. that we will all rise and your weight is not your worth.
I pay a high price to have no regrets and be done with my life. LIFEGOESON. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you're going your own way. LIFEGOESON. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart and you're going your own way. LIFEGOESON. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you're going your own way. LIFEGOESON. What you don't have now